30 seconds.
Make sure everybody out of the way. Yeah, that's pretty good. Hey, Brad, you gonna leave one over there for us? And Slattery? Thank you, Brad. Hey, Jim.
All rise. Hear ye, hear ye, hear ye. This Honorable Court of Common Pleas is now in session pursuant to adjournment. The Honorable John Haas presiding. Please be seated.
Yeah. Good morning.
Good morning, John.
For those of you that are here observing, I will thank you in advance for your decorum. This is a courtroom. I do not expect to hear any outburst of any nature. And your cooperation in that regard will be greatly appreciated. All right. We're here this morning in the case of the State of Ohio versus Lance Mason, case number 18-634887. The State of Ohio is present, represented by Assistant Prosecutor Anna Fraglia. I ask if you would introduce your trial team and to the court.
Thank you, Your Honor. Good morning. Here along with me is Michael O'Malley, who is the County Prosecutor for Cuyahoga County, along with Diane Russell, who is the Chief of the Criminal Division. As part of our team as well is Carson Strang, Assistant County Prosecutor, and Christopher Schroeder, also an Assistant County Prosecutor, and our law enforcement individual is Linda Carlozzi from the Shaker Heights Police Department, Your Honor.
Thank you. And I would note for the record that the defendant is present. I note that the defendant is wearing glasses, so you've been able to read everything this morning okay?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. And Mr. Mason, you have been represented throughout these proceedings by Mr. Kevin Spellacy and Mr. Thomas Shaughnessy. Is that correct?
That's correct. You want me to rise or?
No, you can remain seated, sir.
All right.
Okay? All right. We're going to go over several things. I'm going to take my time. If at any time you do not agree with something I've said or is said by others, let me know. Or if there's something you don't understand, please let me know and we'll discuss it. I'll give you an opportunity to confer with your attorneys. One of the things that I asked of your counsel initially was whether or not there's any medications that you are on that could in any way, shape, or form cause you not to understand or focus on the proceedings this morning.
No, Your Honor.
All right. I would ask you, Mr. Mason, if in fact you are satisfied with the advice of your attorneys.
Yes, Your Honor.
And I would ask them for the record to just give a brief rendition of your years of experience, and I know there's a number of capital cases you've handled, but I want to have in the record the experience that both of you have had in the criminal arena.
Thank you, Judge. Kevin Smellis, Your Honor. I was admitted to practice in November of 1989. I spent 5 years in the county prosecutor's office, approximately actually 4.78 years in the county prosecutor's, according to their PERS. But and then I became a criminal defense lawyer. Practiced in that arena ever since. I think it's my 30th year judge of practice. I've handled many capital murders, many aggravated murders. I've tried cases along with Mr. Shaughnessy in both aggravated and capital situations with success. I can tell you that we both have explained to Mr. Mason the nature of this case, the evidence that the government would present against him. We've made available to him all the discovery that's been given to us in this case, like we would with anyone else, Judge. And we've also listened to his input and abided by his wishes as to how to proceed in certain situations. And I can tell you that it's my professional opinion that today his plea will be knowingly, intelligently, and voluntarily tendered, Your Honor.
Very good. Counsel.
Thank you, Your Honor, for pleasing the court. I was admitted to practice in the state of Ohio in October of 1990. I'm also admitted in the Northern District of the Federal Court of the United States of America. Judge, I was in the public defender's office for 2 or 3 years. I've been doing criminal defense since then. I've probably tried in excess of 150 to 200 jury trials, probably 30 to 40 homicide trials. That would include approximately 9 or 10 capital trials. I would concur with Mr. Spellacy's statements about our conversations with our client. I believe he will enter the plea here today knowingly, intelligently, and voluntarily.
Thank you, counsel. All right, Mr. Mason, what I'm going to do is go over several things with you and make sure you understand them. First of all, I have before me a written plea agreement. As late as 10 minutes ago, there were a couple minor changes being made, but those changes were made. And looking at the signature page, over the line for signature of defendant appears the signature of Lance Mason. Is that your signature?
Yes, Your Honor.
We're going to go over that agreement and stipulation in some detail. A couple things I wanted to go over with you that'll be somewhat covered by that, but I had made notes that I wanted to make sure that we were on the same page. There was a lot of discovery provided to you in this case by the state of Ohio, and my question for you, sir, is were you able to review and read the discovery provided by the state of Ohio?
Yes, Your Honor.
Do you have any issues whatsoever with any lack of discovery provided to you or the nature of the discovery provided to you?
No.
Thank you. One of the things that throughout the proceedings in this case I have questioned your attorneys about, and it's covered somewhat in the written plea agreement, but I wanted to hear you express yourself on this. I questioned the attorneys with regard to motions that I was pretty sure would typically be filed in a case of this nature. And one of the things that was indicated to me was that it was at your request that they were not filing those motions. And for instance, typically in a case of this nature, as you would know, there's a motion for change of venue because of publicity. A defendant may allege that he couldn't get a fair trial in this county. And I expected that motion to be filed, and it was not. And I have been advised that that was at your request. Is that correct?
Your Honor, I wish to take responsibility for the crimes I committed. I don't wish to prolong it or delay it or hurt my family or Aisha's family any more than I have.
And I respect that, and please forgive me for going over this again, but my job is to make a good record, and you know that.
Yes.
And one of the things with regard to the change of venue, had that motion been filed, as you probably well know, what I would have ruled is that I would first attempt to seat a jury And if during that process I did not feel sufficient jurors could be held in Cuyahoga County that can be fair and impartial, then I would transfer the case to another county. But that's the process that's typically done, and I would have been willing to do that. But you have waived that as part of this agreement, and so that motion was not filed. The second motion, which I anticipated would be filed, was a motion relative to your prior conviction. And as you know, if the defendant testifies a prior felony conviction, unless the court rules otherwise, could come in as it relates to credibility. The state has made it known that under Rule 404, which is other acts rule, that they would have intended to bring in that conviction for other purposes. I anticipated that that ruling would have to be made, and I wanted to let you know that I, under 404, which is a rule of exclusion, that I would have to be shown that there's some purpose and that that purpose would not be outweighed to the prejudice to you. So it was not an automatic that a prior conviction would come in under 404 or 403. I never had to make that ruling. Once again, it was your decision not to ask for a motion to limit your motion to test whether or not that can be used at trial if it went to trial. Do you understand what I just said?
Yes, Your Honor.
And was that your decision as well?
My decision was to not go to trial and to admit my guilt.
Okay.
So I waived that also.
All right. And also, again, as it relates to competency of witnesses, especially with minor witnesses, especially with someone under the age of 10, that in fact an issue with regard to competency would have to be addressed, and again, you waived any issues with regard to that. Is that correct?
There's no way I was going to let my daughter testify against me.
Very good.
So yes, I did waive that.
Very good. Also covered in this is that you were allowed to consult with a psychologist, and that it is my understanding from your attorneys that there is absolutely no indication in this case that at the all times relevant, at the time of the incident, that you were not sane at that time, that in fact, as it relates to today and purposes of this plea, that you are competent, that you understand the nature of the proceedings against you, and you are fully capable of assisting your own attorneys in your defense. In other words, the sanity and competency, that there's no indication in the record otherwise that you aren't sane at the time, all times relevant in this case, and not competent in this case. Am I correct in that assumption?
That is correct, Your Honor.
Very good, sir. Very importantly, and this is also covered in the plea agreement, which I'll be going over with you, there's been absolutely no discussion or agreement with regard to sentencing, that the court will entertain a sentencing memo from you, will allow you to call witnesses, should you choose to call witnesses at any time of sentencing, that the court will make a decision at that time. I have not indicated to you one way or the other what that sentence would be. We'll go over what the range of sentencings can be, but there's been no promises made, any indications whatsoever. Am I correct in that?
That is correct.
And would your, the attorney's counsel, would you agree with that?
Yes, I would, Your Honor.
Yes, Judge.
All right, very good. And it's my understanding that if you do enter a plea to the charges this morning, that you will not be requesting a pre-sentence investigation. You will be asking for the opportunity to present at time of sentencing any witnesses or information that you feel is relevant to the sentencing in this case. Am I correct on that?
That's correct, Your Honor.
Do you have any questions, Mr. Mason, with regard to any of the information contained in the written plea agreement?
No, Your Honor.
Did you carefully review that with your attorneys?
Yes, Your Honor.
All right. And specifically, I want to go over a couple things with you. The agreement and the plea would be to count one count of aggravated murder, punishable by a sentence of imprisonment without parole, life with parole eligibility after 20 years of imprisonment, life imprisonment with parole eligibility after serving 25 full years of imprisonment, or life imprisonment with parole eligibility after serving 30 full years of imprisonment, and a fine of not more than $25,000. Did you understand that charge?
Yes, Your Honor.
And the possible penalties?
Yes, Your Honor.
Count two charged you with one count of murder and punishable by an indefinite prison sentence of 15 years to life, a fine not more than $15,000. Did you understand that charge?
Yes, Your Honor.
Count three was one count of felonious assault of Ms. Frazier and a felony of the second degree, punishable by a definite prison sentence of 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, or 8 years, a fine not more than $15,000.
Yes, Your Honor.
Count four was a violation of a protection order, and it's a felony of the third degree, punishable by a definite prison sentence of 9, 12, 18, 24, 30, or 36 months, a fine not more than $10,000.
Yes, Your Honor.
Count five, grand theft of an Audi SUV, felony of the fourth degree, punishable by a definite prison sentence of 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, or 18 months, and a fine not more than $5,000.
Yes, Your Honor.
In count six, one count of felonious assault of Adam Flint, a peace officer, a felony of the first degree, punishable by a definite prison sentence of 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, or 11 years, and a fine of not more than $20,000.
Yes, Your Honor.
You understand those were the charges against you?
Yes.
And you understand that pursuant to this agree, you'd be entering a plea of guilty to those counts?
Correct.
And it's your understanding that count one, aggravated murder, count two, murder, count three, felonious assault, are allied offenses of similar import and will merge for purposes of sentencing, and that the state will elect to proceed to sentencing on count one, aggravated murder?
Yes, Your Honor.
And you further understand and stipulate that count one, aggravated murder, count four, violating a protection order, count five, grand theft, count six, felonious assault, each pertain to separate acts committed with a separate animus, and as such, the parties agree that none of those counts will merge at sentencing. Do you understand that?
Can you repeat that, Your Honor?
Sure. And do you have a copy of that in front of him that he can look at that? I'm looking at paragraph number 16. If you want to read that over, and if your attorney has, you want to ask your attorney about that.
Okay. I understand, Your Honor.
All right. Very good, sir. Very importantly, you understand if you ever are released from prison that you will be subject to a mandatory period of post-release supervision for 5 years in a violation of any of those conditions would lead to periods of re-imprisonment up to one half the sentence imposed.
Yes, Your Honor.
Do you have any questions with regard to any of the things I've raised?
No.
All right. I'm going to go over now the basic rights that you have that it's my understanding that you are going to waive on today's date. You have an absolute right to have a trial by jury or a trial to the court. You have an absolutely right to confront any witnesses brought in to testify against you. Your attorneys could cross-examine those witnesses on your behalf. You also have a right through the subpoena process to require to be brought to court those witnesses who might testify on your behalf. You also have a right to require the state of Ohio to prove each and every element of the offenses by burden of proof beyond a reasonable doubt. And you also have a right to remain silent. You cannot be compelled to testify against yourself. In essence, by entering a plea of guilty, you would be testifying against yourself. Do you understand each and every one of those rights I just went over?
Yes, Your Honor.
Is it your decision to give up those rights, to waive those rights?
Yes, Your Honor.
You also have a right to appeal any decisions made by the court with regard to any throughout this case, and you'd be giving up your right of appeal with regard to any decisions made by the court. Do you understand that?
Yes, Your Honor.
Do you have any questions about that?
No, Your Honor.
Do you understand that you will be sentenced to prison? You will not be given a community control sanction?
Yes, Your Honor.
Is there anything further from the state of Ohio that you wish me to put in the record at this point in time?
The only other thing, Your Honor, is that by pleading guilty, he will be designated a violent offender and will have to register for 10 years.
Thank you.
On his release. Thank you.
And to that end, I have a document in front of me, notice of duties to enroll as a violent offender. And over the line for the signature of offender is the signature of Lance Mason. Is that your signature?
Yes, Your Honor.
Did you review that with your attorneys?
Yes.
And you understand your responsibilities pursuant to that?
Yes, Your Honor.
Mr. Mason, then if we're at that point, I'm going to ask you how you plead to count one, aggravated murder.
Guilty.
How do you plead to count two, murder?
Guilty.
How do you plead to count three, felonious assault, Alyssa Frazier?
Guilty.
How do you plead to count four, violating a protection order?
Guilty, Your Honor.
How do you plead to count five, grand theft?
Guilty.
How do you plead to count six, felonious assault?
Guilty, Your Honor.
Court accepts the plea of guilty, finds you guilty with regard to each and every one of those accounts. It's my understanding that both sides will be afforded the opportunity to present the court with a sentencing memorandum. I have, after consulting with the attorneys, we have established a sentencing day for September the 12th at 1 p.m. I would ask that counsel provide me with your sentencing memo prior to that date so I can review that and be prepared for that hearing. If in fact there is a witness that you wish to call or someone, both the state of Ohio and the defense, that interferes with that particular date, let me know. We'll try to arrange an alternative date. Anything further from the state of Ohio?
Nothing, Your Honor. Thank you very much.
Anything from the defense?
Nothing else, Your Honor. Thank you very much.
All right, you may remain seated yet, okay? And to those of you in the back, thank you for your courtesy. And we stand in recess. Thank you for your cooperation. You may be seated. All right. Council, want to approach? How do you want to handle the?
I'll find it right now.
Well, it's all fine.
Good.
Okay. I'm going to need to sign a sentence and entry, and you're going to provide that for me.
Yeah, is that right?
Okay.
All right.
And this is ready to go then. Okay. All right. Anything further?
No, sir. Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Thanks.
What about the file?
It's right here. And I'll sign that.
And I think I took that action.
Pardon me?
You do that in sentencing.
Well, I'll do it again.
Yeah.
That way I covered it both ways.
Yeah.
Okay.